Greg Baird from NorthernVoice.com and Meepers.com. How are you? Yes, I know I'm holding the camera while I'm driving, but I'm watching the road. A little stressed out, but I'm in Louisville, Kentucky. I hope I said that right. And I'm heading east to Morehead State because I'm doing a lecture tonight at MSU, which is Morehead State University. And actually, I'm in a rental car. Had the wrong exit, so I had to turn completely around. Now I'm going the right direction, so I'm a little bit more calm. But anyway, the lecture should be great. Some really great people. I'm right near the Appalachian Mountains, and it's kind of a gloomy day. Some thunderstorms are on the way, but the storm I'm making tonight is going to make a lot of people's lives brighter, I hope, down the road, and you're coming with me. So enjoy this little journey while I'm heading east to Morehead State University. So I just passed, here in Kentucky, a BP station, which is, if you didn't know out there, it's British Petroleum. Go get gas. You know you're in Kentucky when the BP sells biscuits and gravy while you get a fill up. Love it. Onward we go. Shout it out.
LGBTQ community. There is nothing more important than having an ally, somebody that's with you through thick and through thin in your life that understands you. If they don't understand you, share your story. Share both your stories. And when I say about being an ally, I mean being an ally 100% of the time. Those of you that are sitting in here, how many of you have been around a group of friends and a gay joke has come up or the word faggot has been used and you've laughed just to be with the crowd? Because if you feel you speak up, they're going to think that either you're gay or why are you defending them? And it's important as we go on in life that we have our allies, because our ally is the core of what's going to create equality for all of us, along with the LGBTQ community. But we need our straight allies. You may not understand, but make sure you have a desire to change and understand. I'm thinking, why is Dr. Ruthman asking me this question? Did I say something to her? Or does she feel sorry for me because of the outfit I wore the night before? I weigh 80 pounds heavier, and it looks like I have a vest out of a bad motel. Isn't that awful? And the thing was, I wore that thing so damn much that it was kind of midriff. You know, like I was wearing like a gay man's halter top. So I'm thinking, like, you know, looking at her in her flower dress and me, I mean, now you're a couple that you go to prom, you know. So I'm thinking, oh my God, so I said to her, I go, well, Dr. Ruth, it's because, you know, I live in a residence hall, an apartment off the residence hall. And I'm thinking the whole time while I'm saying this to her, lame ass excuse, lame. She goes, oh, I mean, she was ready to explode. She goes, you go out with the boys. Underneath, she goes again, like, oh my God, she knows where I'm going. How does she know this? I will tell you, as a gay man, and a lot of you can understand this if you're LGBTQ, you mean queer. You can ask me later about that. We can be the best liars because we've had to hide who we are. And when that sets in and festers for the longest time, it's not a good situation because it affects everything and everybody around us. Am I not right? Some of you that are in here that are not, that know what I'm talking about. So I finally said, I'm going to tell her. So I called her back in. She's standing at the bottom of the stairs. Now, let me tell you, if I look past my mother, it was raging and ready to explode in the morning. If you look past her, you can see the screen door that goes out to the front of the house. There's a reason why I'm telling you that. So I said, and this little boy said, tell her. And this other boy said, don't tell her, you're going to lose everything. Tell her, don't tell her, you're going to lose it. You're going to like be homeless. Now I'm thinking like, damn, I only got like 70 bucks in my everything, for a college student. So I said, do you want me to tell you that I'm gay? Do you want me to tell you that I'm a homosexual? Yes, I am, and I'm proud of it. Long pause. I could hear the wind coming through the windows upstairs in the house. My mother looked at me and she goes, well, good. Turned around, threw open the front door of the house. Threw open the front door of the house, got into the front lawn, the center of our manicured lawn, threw her hands up like a Vita, and she goes, my son's gay! I have a gay son, Jesus Christ! She's like freaking out. Gay and saying Jesus Christ at the same time next to the Baptist minister that's next door is not the best thing to do. Quality across the board like everybody else has. I want the same kind of benefits that my straight counterparts have. You can marry over 1,100 different kinds of rules, regulations, laws that could go with my partner or not. So when I was out in Washington in October, it was amazing to see the people rallying for human rights, and it's human rights for all. And I love that there were straight allies there, a lot of people your age was there. Encourage yourself to understand the older community, the LGBT community as well, because a lot of those people that are older have been there and have been activists from the very beginning. They have a wealth of history. I was just saying this earlier, if none of us that are gay are not sharing our history, no one else is going to do it for us. They'll be lost. They're not teaching in school, they're not educating in school at all. Maybe we might talk a little bit about how they know, but that's about it.
Friday morning and I'm heading back to Louisville. I had my lecture last night at MSU, Morehead State University. It was awesome. So I want to thank the programming board, but above all, I want to thank everybody that came and the Alliance group on campus. They were sweethearts. They were wonderful. We had a great time afterwards. A little food and conversations. So thank you to everybody there. I love the work that I do. I love inspiring people and that's just about what life is all about. So, gotta watch my driving. I'm heading home, but it was a great event, and thanks to everybody. But nothing bothers me. I can knock them scales all right. 6 days on the road, and I'm gonna make it home tonight. Well, my rig's a little low, but that don't mean she's slow.